Round four of the 2012 Intercontinental Rally Championship, and it's another rally on an island. But the Tour de Course is more than just a rally on an island. It's one of the all-time tarmac legends. The Giro di Corsica welcomes the IRC base, not just around Ajaccio, but around four centres, Bastia in the north, Calvicote in the mountains, and the capital, Ajaccio. 3 days, a total of 318 tight and twisting kilometres of stage mileage. Well, Corsica is a mountainous peak thrown up in the Mediterranean between the south of France and Italy and Sardinia. It visits four different centres, but the overriding concern here is its famous name. The Rally of 10,000 Corners, that seems to be an underestimation of the challenge facing the drivers on the legendary Tour de Corse. So drivers getting ready to leave service in Ajaccio, heading for the first stage of round four, the IRC. And the final preparation for the cars, once they're on the island, is to fit the tyres. Dominic Bravi from Michelin Competition talks tyres with the drivers and with us. The choice for day one will be obvious. They're going to have to go hard compound. It's tight, it's twisty, it's abrasive on Corsica. A soft slick will give you grip, but not for long enough.
It is the best choice because it's very abrasive, it's a long way, near 70 kilometers. Oh, it is.
And tyre wear, what about that?
It's difficult to say. Last year, it was same mileage and the tyres were okay. Maybe, you know, if you are pushing too much, then it can be on the limit, but I think with Michelin tyres, it should be okay.
It's for sure hard compound. If not, I'm very mistaken as a big clouds is coming, but as for now, it looks absolutely terrific and I can't wait to get out on the stages. Tyre wear will be a problem, I think. Some long stages, this loop. So the question is to bring one spare or two spares. So maybe we'll go for the safe option in the beginning.
We will use the harder compound now because it's very abrasive surface and also it's really good weather. And the stages are very twisty, so but I think with the Michelin tyres it will be no problem.
Tour de Corse is legendary for the twisty nature of the stages, and this is what we mean by twisty. Around every corner, there's another corner.
Right, only if you want to break it comes with him in my plan.
Well, tour de course literally means lap of Corsica, and they pretty much complete an entire lap of the island. The crew's taking in some fabulous natural scenery, if only they had time to enjoy it. This volcanic mountainous outcrop is a real work of Mother Nature. Heading into the last stage of day one, passing through tiny mountainous villages, reigning IRC champion Andreas Mikkelsen leads the rally. Well, Andreas Mikkelsen meeting World Touring Car driver Rob Huff,
calculated from what I gain,
driving one of the course cars over the event.
I see at Eurosport about coming out to one of the rallies, obviously both organised by Eurosport events.
Well, while Mikkelsen and Huff chat on, Giandomenico Basso is stuck on a road section heading to the overnight service. He was fighting for the lead, but hitting a rock broke the Ford suspension and its terminal. The Fiesta is out. Giandomenico's chances of victory are gone. Early morning in Calvi, the drivers preparing for day two of the Tour de Course. I'm here in the space you made. Lights that begin to fade. Just fold back the page. And watch the words tumble. In the small village of La Porta, we catch up with Pascal Cunazon, the director of Michelin competition. So once you get into rallying, you really become a fan very easily. It's a massive adrenaline boost. It offers really so much. Breathtaking landscape, passionate fans. For us as well, of course, it's like a huge laboratory. It's fascinating. It throws up so many different variables. We go all over the place. We encounter dozens, hundreds of different road surfaces, different temperatures, different weather conditions. We have to cope with all of that. Once you get the best tyre, you've got to get the best compromise between the road surface and the car and how it works for the driver. For the surface, for instance, if you've got to know if it's smooth, if it's granular, the car, the suspension setup, geometry, you've got to know, and of course the driver, the information he gets from the tyre so he knows how hard he can push, whether the car's at the limit or not. It's all part of the equation. Well, Tour de Corse highlighted the Super 2000 battle between the new 1.6 turbo cars and the previous normally aspirated 2-litre cars. The 1.6 turbo in the Mini, lower revving and more torquey. The 2 litres, well, they just love to be revved.
I think when it's really twisty, I think they will have an advantage, but where it's more fast and open, then we will have an advantage. So I think it's more or less the same on this rally.
Well, that was Skoda's Anders Mikkelsen after shakedown. Here we compare the Mini of Danny Sordo and Jan Kopecky in the Skoda Fabia, the 2-litre normally aspirated car. And it just seems to have a little bit more legs on the Mini right at the upper rev range. But the Mini's torque pulls it out of the corner nicely, barely losing any ground at all to the Skoda. They do seem to have done the sums right. The cars are closely matched on the twisty stuff. Into service, and of course, as the mechanics check over the car, then the tyres get changed as well. And more question marks for the drivers and teams to answer. Well, day two turned out to be a disaster for rally leader Anders Mikkelsen. On stage five, felling a telegraph pole, he picked up, incredibly, only a puncture. But on stage eight, he picked up another. By the end of day two, Mikkelsen was only fifth, almost 4 minutes behind the new rally leader, Danny Sordo. The IRC drivers put on an astonishing show. The Corsican stage is fast and demanding. They demand speed, they demand bravery as well, with big drops, fresh air into the ocean and onto the rocks at the edge of almost every corner. With Mikkelsen's tyre woes, Danny Sordo in the Mini is the rally leader. Jan Kopecky's Skoda, Pierre Campana and Brian Bouffier third and fourth in the revised Peugeot 207s. So the four-wheel drive cars battle at the head of the field in the two-wheel drive car. This is a great all-Renault battle. The little Clio R3 and the bigger Mégane M4. The R3 with Pierre-Antoine Guglielmi and Manu Gigou is in the Mégane. Both 2-litre engines, the Mégane turbocharged, so more horsepower. But on these tight and twisty stages, the light, nimble Clio holds its own superbly. In the end, both Renault drivers went out on stage six. Gigou crashed his Renault Sport Technology Mégane while leading the two-wheel drive cup. And Pierre-Antoine Guglielmi was forced to retire. His Clio caught fire when he was lying in second place in the two-wheel drive cup. No such dramas, though, for Mini's Danny Sordo, who's built up a lead of around 20 seconds, controlling the rally. The new John Cooper Works regional rally car leads. Jan Kopecky holding on to second in the Skoda Fabia, but he's got a battle on his hands. the rev limiter in top gear on these narrow lanes, and he needs to be. He's being chased hard from behind. Pierre Campana in the Peugeot 207 is a local. He's from Corsica, and he's closing in on Capecchi, determined to improve on third place. Meanwhile, he too is under threat. Brian Bouffier, an IRC veteran now, charging hard from fourth place. He could easily end up on the podium. They race on into the sunset. There's to be drama for Jean-Dominique Mattei. The Frenchman ends his rally on day two and was fortunate to be able to get out of his Skoda Fabia as it caught light. The crew were okay. The car will never be used again. Day three, the final day's action on the Tour de Corse, and the boss of Michelin Tires is once again out on the stages to see the tires and the cars in action. You can see on this corner here, car really having to work the tire hard, really hard on the shoulder of the tires. Really important to have a hard compound that lasts here, that won't overheat. But on the other hand, up and down the hills, you need lots of acceleration, so a soft compound offers a better traction. But it's important to find a good balance, and that's the tire manufacturer's job, to hit the best balance. Another really important factor is what the road surface is like. We know, we have to know whether it's smooth, whether it's granular, how worn it is, whether it's smooth or soft. So we've got this panel here that represents a number of different surface types we'll find here during the rally. Each part of the stage might have different types of surface. We've got to match the tire compound for a series of stages to the surfaces it'll encounter. Well, day two stages centered around Corte. The surface is quite different from that found during day one around Ajaccio. Day three, different again. Yesterday, the surface was pretty granular, but fairly worn. Today, the road surface still granular, but more worn. So we're on a different type of surface. And so we're on that particular type. So when you develop the tire, you've got to understand the road surface to be able to produce a good product. One of the great things about rallying is that although the experts make it look, well, not easy, you know that everyone's just a moment away from disaster.
Two, right? have to fend off that two left.
Heading back into service then. Time for the mechanics to work on the cars, for the tyre technicians to check the tyres used in the previous stages and offer up advice. Danny Sordo still leads the rally and everything seems to be going nice and smoothly for the Spaniard, his Mini and the ProDrive team. Well, today and yesterday we've been using the Michelin SA30, says Jean-Patrice. They worked pretty well, everything was fine, so no problems for us. The rally and a debut win for the new John Cooper Works regional rally car are Sordo's to give away, but behind there's still an epic battle for second. Jan Capecchi trying to hold off local hero Pierre Campana. Capecchi lost time with a couple of moments, but he's come back fighting strongly. Campana hasn't driven this kind of car for quite some while, but the Corsican knows the nature of these stages, and he overhauls Capecchi for second on the final day. Well, Capecchi in the Skoda with a green tail trailed Campana all the way through this stage. The Czech struggled with his notes. He really didn't have confidence. His first time on the island, Corsica is a daunting place for even the best. But on the next run through the stage, the notes tidied up, the confidence restored, the Czech would go fastest. Regrouping before the service park in Mazzinaggio, Campana's co-driver Sabrina checking in for the time control. Mickelson and co-driver Flern hiding from the sun. Capecchi decides that he wants to go for a little bit of a cool down, so he heads off to the sea as Mickelson and his co-driver top up their tans. Oh, but Capecchi makes a mistake. He gets away with it, but his phone is toast. Danny Sordo can relax and concentrate on the final few stages. Well, this is Andreas Aigner in the Subaru Impreza R4. The Austrian wins the production cup in Corsica. No mistakes, no dramas for him. Pretty flawless rally. He now looks favourite to take the IRC Production Cup title. He had an advantage of 3 minutes 23 seconds over closest rival Toshi Arai. Legend Francois Delacour is back. His Mégane M4 may not have challenged for overall victory. He had brake issues as well on the long stages on the final day to finish third in the Production Cup, leading car in the M4 class as well. Well, Petru Anton Buschetti was the surpriser in a two-wheel drive cup in his Renault Clio R3. Hadn't driven a rally car of any kind for more than 6 months. Gulp before heading to the Tour de Corse. So congratulations to him. And congratulations too to Danny Sordo. After Basso's retirement and Mickelson's mishap, Sordo was in control. He was fast, fluent and mistake-free. Several times a podium finisher on the WRC. He was a junior world rally champion, but yet to win a major rally outright. In Corsica, Danny Sordo put that right. If you're going to win somewhere as a tarmac expert, this is as tough as they come. Well, after his small off on day one, Capecchi came back strongly, finally winning the battle for second against local hero Campana, winning all but one stage on the final day. He won 6 of the 14 tests on the Tour de Corse, despite not feeling entirely at home on this fast tarmac. The Czech was presented with the Colin McRae flat-out trophy for this charging display of bravery. Not to be sniffed at on Corsica. So the overall classification, it's a debut win for Danny Sordo at the top level and for the John Cooper Works Mini. regional rally car. Jan Kopecky taking second. Points in fifth for series leader Andreas Mikkelsen. A great sixth for Craig Breen as well, flying throughout his first visit to Tour de Corse. And that then is it for Corsica. Next time, oh, it's another tarmac rally. It's another island. They head to Sicily for round 5.